Hello and welcome to Prego Coding Classes. This is Amber Roy, and in today's video we'll learn about the topics that you are seeing on screen. The first topic would be learn more about the edit test control. We'll talk about the edit test control more and we'll learn more. So the second one would be how to show and hide the action bar that is present on the layout. And the third one would be we'll know more about the constraint layout and how it works. And the fourth topic would be we'll make an app with condition statements that will take credentials from the user, that is the user ID and password, and if it matches with what we're looking for, it will change the activity to the second activity. So if you do not know what I'm talking about, what I'm working with, please see the other two videos that has been posted on this channel. And if you have already seen it, so welcome to this video. Let's get started. So friends, previously we have made an app that will take two numbers from the users, the first number and the second number, and when you hit the calculate, it will show the result by summing up these numbers, by adding these numbers. So first of all, we'll delete all the controls from here. And delete all the programming that has been done previously. In this video, we'll start fresh. So the first topic would be, we'll know more about the edit text control. So this is the whole edit text control panel. And the types of edit text control that you can import are plain text, password field, password numeric, email, phone, etc., etc. So we can find and select the edit text that we want from this list. But if you do not want to work that hard, we can just drag and drop the plain text, the first one that receives all types of characters, and then as I've said in my previous videos, we can select the input type from here. So the input type can be changed from this field. Now, input types are text, text cap characters, text cap words, text cap sentences, text autocorrect, and a lot of things. So choose the correct one that suits your application. So for this application, we need a user ID. So I'll just choose the text field. Yes, let's choose the text field. So input type is text. And here you can make customization to this control. Like you can provide a hint. Let's first delete the name that is in the text. All right, so we can provide a hint. Now, what is a hint? Hint is just a message that is shown before you click the control. Like if you want to get the user ID from the user and you want to tell the user that this field is for the user ID only, let's just type a hint for the user. Do it once again. Type your user ID. Now, when the user clicks it, this hint will disappear automatically and the user can input his or her text on the text field. So let's see how this works. But first, this red exclamation mark is for constraining the layout or constraining the control to this layout. So let's constrain it from every side. So the right side, let's constrain left, top, and bottom. Now let's see how the hint works. Let's just run it in our phone. And today we'll use our phone, not the emulator, because emulator slows down my computer a bit. So the app has been installed in my phone and we'll see how the app looks now. So as I said, it is asking the user to type the user ID, and this is a hint. Now see what happens when I type something. I'll just type. And as I type, the hint is automatically erased by the control. Now when I backspace the whole thing, the hint again comes forward. So this works to let the user know what the control actually wants from the user. You can hint the user rather. Let's just drag it up. Okay. Now, how the text appears. So you can change the font from here. There are pre-installed fonts. And you can also change how the text would look like in this edit text. You can make the text bold, italics. You can also select the color of the text. You can select the size of the text. And now I'm not going very in depth into this control, because if I go very in depth, I have to work from this layout field in here, and you won't understand it right now. So let's just keep it very simple and straight. Now, this is for the edit text control. And the second topic is, we'll know how to show and hide the action bar. So, as I've said previously in my other video, that our style controls how this layout really looks like. So, as you can see in the first line, style name, app theme, it's a theme that you have given to the layout. So, the parent theme is dark action bar. So, this is an action bar where the demo application is written. So we can customize it by writing no action bar. And when you look at the layout, the action bar is erased by itself. And again, if you want it, write dark action bar. Again, it appears. Now, this can be done in two ways, from the style itself, and then again, from the main activity.java. Now, how to do that from the Java class file? So, we'll write get support action bar as it is shown in here. We'll just press tab dot. When you do this, the action bar is hidden when the application is fired up. So on create, when the application creates itself, the support action bar is set to hide. It won't show. Now these are the two ways you can hide the action bar. Now the third topic is how to control or work with the constraint layout. So I'll teach you as we put other controls inside this layout, and we'll work with it. So our motto is to get the user ID and password from the user, and then check how the user ID and password is either right or wrong. It uses what we want, or it matches what we want or not. So get another plain text inside. Now click the bottom constraint part and connect bottom control with the top control. Connect the left, right, and leave the bottom as it is. So what did I do? I made this control a parent and this control its child. So when I move it, the bottom one also moves. It's just a bonding that I've created in between these two controls. So when I move the below, the bottom control, nothing happens. But when I move the top one, the bottom one moves. So the top one is the parent and the bottom one is the child. Now I'll need a button. So let's just write a button in here and we'll change the button name, button text to also constrain the left and the right. Now we'll make this button a child of the top control like this. The bottom would be as it is. And let's just put it below the second control. Now what did I do? Now if you move the second control, which would be our password field, the bottom one also moves. But remember, this control is constrained to the second control, which is constrained to the first control. So this is the parent of these two controls. And this is the parent of this control. So when I move the first one, the whole thing moves. So as I said, this is the parent of these two controls. So this is how to work with the constraint layout. Now the fourth topic is, we're going to make an app with condition statements that will decide whether to switch between activities or not depending on the credential that has been given by the user. And which, if it matches the credential that we want, then only the activity changes, else an error message is shown. Now, to do that, we'll first need to change this field to a password field. And as I have said, just change the input type. So we need a text password. And if you can see the name text that was there is now hidden. So we'll just type password. And let's just do one thing, just delete the text and put a hint. Gives a hint to the user to type his or her password. And when the user hits the submit button, it takes us to the second activity that we're going to create. If the credentials are right, else an error message is shown. So we're not going to put the text view to show the error message here. Rather, we would use a toast message, which will disappear automatically. And I'll show you what a toast message is in this video. So first, let's cast the controls into a variable. So as the previous videos, I forgot to put the IDs. So this control ID would be edit text ID. And this one would be